This followed a recommendation made in the report on the ad hoc committee on Bujagali tax waiver, where the committee chairperson, Dickson Kateshumbwa, the MP Shema municipality, revealed that following a scrutiny of the tariffs computation and equity shares injected in by government, the total payment of Bujagali Energy Limited from 2012 to 2022 by government were too high.
It strongly calls upon Parliament to compare government of Uganda to renegotiate the Bujagali Energy Limited power purchase agreement terms before deciding on the issue of the tax. This is in addition to recovery of all excess payments and the application of proper figures in the calculation of the capacity payments going forward.
Kateshumbwa argued that the hemorrhage and repatriation of resources from Uganda have been modernized through treaties and memorandums of understanding, where investors represented by sophisticated lawyers impose misery terms on the government and employ tax dodgers to bleed profits from the poor situations in which the government finds itself. The Select Committee report argued that at the time the concession was entered, the government was in a poor bargaining position. It did not have the resources to fund the project, and the country could not afford any further delays.
It is of the opinion that government should intentionally protect the public interest and always take an active lead role in monitoring strategic and significant projects such as Bujagali Energy Limited, regardless of the circumstances.
The probe into Bujagali's relationship with government followed a recommendation during the consideration of the Income Tax Amendment Bill 2022 on 18th May 2022, where Parliament stayed the extension of a five-year corporate income tax waiver until an investigation with its dealings with government is probed.
Evidence provided to the committee as to when the parties ever agreed on the reasonable income tax payable by the company. This was a violation of the power purchase agreement.
Parliament also wants the Inspectorate of Government to probe into the operations of the Electricity Regulatory Authority in the amortization of the return on equity of Bujagali Energy Limited to establish culpable officers of the Electricity Regulatory Authority who amortized a wrong return of equity for Bujagali Energy Limited with a view of prosecution.
When you look at Karuma, look at Isimba, look at all these other dams, we are paying dimmed energy that we are not using. We should come up with a good negotiation on how we come up with a price for dimmed energy.
This, the team that has been running the contract at Bujagali has been withdrawing money for the last 10 years. They are also telling us that they understated taxes, or they showed that they should not be paying taxes to a tune of $63 million. They're also talking about the losses on insurance, I think on page 25. But when they come to the conclusion, they are saying we renegotiate. Really, finding all these misstatements.
You know, the renegotiation is because we are in an agreement.
Which is okay, Madam Speaker. I agree with you. But before we think of renegotiation, I want the Honorable Attorney General to give us terms on which we can change, in which we can terminate this contract.
The recommendation by the ad hoc committee on Bujagali is to have the Auditor General audit Bujagali Energy Limited as per the National Audit Act, given that the government is a shareholder in the project.
If the contracted capacity is 250, the other costs that are variables that go into producing 250, which are estimated, but you produce at 160, that means those costs are overstated. And that's why we recommended the value for money audit.
Attorney General Chidiowa Chiwanuka welcomed the findings and recommendations in the report and asked Parliament to accord government 3 months to study the report and report back on some of the actions that have been taken.
Right now, Right Honorable Speaker, we are here as the executive asking Parliament to allow a tax waiver. And Parliament is saying, no, we need you to do this. So we need to go back and then come back to Parliament and say, this is what we think we need to do in order to save this whole situation for all of us as a country.
Take audit and report back within 2 months on the audit, on one, the amounts that are supposed to be refunded, how much contribution, how much we are supposed to get as dividends.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.